Hola, bienvenidos a la clase de Español 101. Soy señora Christie, su maestra. Maestra means teacher en español, and in the Latino culture, you can call people by their title to show respect. So while in English saying hello, teacher, would sound strange, in the Spanish-speaking world, it's actually quite appropriate, just as calling your aunt tía or your cousin primo would be used instead of saying their name. It's about giving respect to the places people have in your life, both in your family and in your work. So you can call me Señora Christie, Mrs. Christie, like you would in the United States, or just Maestra, since I'm your teacher. With that short culture lesson, I welcome you to an elementary Spanish course that focuses on learning the basics of the Spanish language and culture. While how much you learn ultimately depends on the work and the effort that you put into it, at the end of this course, everyone should be able to ask and answer questions about specific topics like your personal information, things that you like or don't, activities that you do, things like that. This class requires absolutely no prior Spanish knowledge. If you have taken Spanish in the past or have parents who spoke Spanish to you, please see the placement test folder in the Empiece aquí or the Start Here button. If you are a beginner and you want to learn the basics about the language and the culture, this is the course for you. Since this is a Spanish course, in future videos, I will mainly be speaking Spanish. And that statement might scare you a little. Maybe it doesn't make sense since I just told you that you're not required to know any Spanish. But the best way to learn a language is to use it. So the more you put into it and challenge yourself, the more you'll get out of it. Believe that you can do it. I will try to use Spanish that I think you can probably understand based on what you know, what you've learned, and what the situation is. Just because you don't know exactly what a word means doesn't mean that you can't understand what is being said. If you don't understand, it's okay. That's part of the process. Try not to get frustrado or frustrada if you're a girl. But take advantage of the oportunidad, if in the very least, just to become familiar with the language. Challenge yourself. As in a live class, you'll be required to participate. However, unlike a live class, you can't sit in the back corner and let everyone else do the talking. You have to participate to get the credit. An example of that is for the discussion boards. They're labeled conversaciones. You have to post your comment and respond to two other classmates' posts. For all the work in the course, you'll be responsible and graded based on your part. You are also required to attend two collaborate sessions this semester. Those sessions will be all about working together to meet your language goals. We'll practice for your oral presentations, answer any questions that you have, and go over any homework for in Connect that you're struggling with. It's a time for you to work with your instructor and your classmates face to face and get encouragement and help in the language learning process. So check the schedule and plan which session you can attend before midterm and which you can attend before the final. Now let's talk about the time that goes into this course. Since you're taking an online course, that's basically a course that works at your pace. You do have due dates, though, for assignments, and they're every 2 days, and this is to help kind of space out the work. Keep in mind that you're doing in 4 weeks, which is basically 4 times more what students do in a regular 16-week semester. That turns out to be a full-time job of Spanish work for 4 weeks. With that being said, the time it actually takes you is going to depend on how much you really want to learn. How much time and effort you put in it will ultimately correlate with what you get out of it. While most requirements would tell me that you should plan to spend at least 36 hours a week on this course, I want to focus on telling you to allow yourself the time to really learn. Make your attitude not just that you want to get it done or pass the course. Think about the opportunity to really learn something. Make that your goal and allow yourself a significant amount of time each day to dedicate to learning. This is a 100-level course and is doable if you do the work to the best of your ability. I believe that while we all learn at different paces, everyone can learn. Follow the course calendar, complete all the work, and do it to the best of your ability. There are a lot of little assignments that make up the course, and it's imperative that you follow the course calendar in order to stay on schedule. Moreover, language is not meant to be learned in big chunks. It's better to learn a little bit at a time. You have due dates every 2 days that encourage you to spread out the work and not wait until the end of the week to do all the assignments. Even though you have 2 days for each module, it's not recommended that you wait until the last days and hours to do the work. You'll not be able to get the most out of it, nor retain a lot of information. So don't cheat yourself. Instead, give yourself the time to really learn. All assignments are opened in advance to allow you to work ahead, and due dates are established to help pace you. You have 2 OOPS passes to use for the summer course. Check out the syllabus for more information and use them wisely. Other than the OOPS passes, you will not have access to submit assignments after the closing due date. All Blackboard assignments, tests, and Connect work will close at 11:59 p.m. of the date in which they are due. Your first assignment of the course scavenger hunt will help you to explore what to expect, what you need to complete the course, how the course is set up, and the resources available to you. In the Start Here button, you have your computer set up. Paso 1, step 1, and the important resource information, paso 2, to review. The last step, paso 3, will link you to the syllabus and how to get started on your assignments. Once you work through paso 1, 2, y 3, you're ready to work through the modules in Tarea Asignaciones. Every day, you'll work from this button. Tarea is the Spanish word for homework. All assignments for your course are found in this button. This is pretty much where you'll live after you get through the Start Here tab. Tarea includes everything you need to know and do. For the midterm and the final, you'll have an option of taking the exam live with me on campus at the date stated in your calendar, or you can pay $10 per exam to take it during the test time frame with an online proctor at the location and time most convenient for you. While you do have a midterm and a final, all the work is divided up into 12 modules. You'll also have 4 checkpoints with 4 practice tests to help you prepare. For each module, you'll see a checklist. There are 2 folders in each module. One is module readings, and this includes every resource that you need to complete your assignments. Let's take a look at module 1 readings, for example. You see the syllabus, which you'll need for your first scavenger hunt quiz, Tegrity information to post your introductory video, and course content. For each lesson, there's a PowerPoint that you can view from Blackboard. You can download it or enlarge it. You also see a link titled Tegrity. This is a link to the video of your instructor going through the PowerPoint. Also in this folder is your link to the discussion boards called Conversaciones, to that information. There are plenty of resources included in this folder, both from your instructor, your textbook, and online. It's up to you to decide which and how much of the resources you need to complete the assignments. In the module assignments folders, that's where you'll see what you need to do and includes the links to quizzes, practice tests, the Turnitin document, all those kinds of things. If you have trouble completing an assignment, maybe you need to look back in the readings folder as your resource. If you feel overwhelmed right now, don't worry. You can do it. Si se puede. We're all in this together. There's a Collaborate Help session, question and answer, on Wednesday night at 6:30 p.m. on June the 8th. Come ask any and all questions that you have and meet your classmates. You can also reach me by email or talk to your classmates through the FAQ discussion board in Conversaciones. Although this video is through YouTube, your future videos will be done in Tegrity, a program supported by Blackboard that allows you and I to record presentations that show our screens and also the webcam stream. You can access this through the Tegrity Classes button. For your first video assignment in Module 1, you'll see information about Tegrity in the Readings folder and the list of information you need to include in the Assignments folder. If you have problems with your computer or Tegrity, the information for Blackboard support is located in Paso 2 in Start Here tab. It's important that you get Tegrity to work, as all of your lectures and your class presentations will be done in that program. Now it's time for you to explore. If you have any questions, email is the best way to get a hold of me. Good luck. Mucha suerte. And I look forward to working with you soon. See you soon. Hasta pronto.